Isaac Nwagaba, commonly known as Mugisha, has admitted to the murder of several women and revealed where bodies were buried. The Crime Intelligence Unit arrested three suspects believed to be part of a notorious taxi gang responsible for a series of murders of women in Kajansi in Wakiso district. The gang was allegedly involved in abducting women who were either going to work early in the morning or returning home late at night. The victims were strangled and robbed of their belongings, and their bodies were dumped in various locations. Muchiga was arrested with three of his accomplices, including Abbas Katongole and Ronald Matovu, both conductors of a taxi with number UAU-738T and Herbert Priyashemerera. During a media briefing at the police headquarters in Naguru in Kampala, the police spokesperson Fred Nanga detailed the operation that led to the arrests.
Netubakubiriza okutambulira wamu mu grupu zaabwe. Buli lw'oyawukana ku lugendo kikuviirako oluusi okufuna okusoomoozebwa ku kkubo.
The taxi which was aiding the murders was impounded and is currently parked at Kajansi Police Division. The National Unity Platform President Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, commonly known as Bobi Wine, has withdrawn his complaint from the Uganda Human Rights Commission, which he filed against the government 5 years ago. He accuses security agencies of allegedly blocking his music concerts and confiscating music equipment, among other issues. Bobi Wine also accused the commission and its chairperson, Mariam Wangadia, of lacking impartiality in hearing his case. During the engagement, the new president said the commission, which is empowered by the constitution to protect constitutional rights, is the one violating them. Responding to Chagulani's claims, Wangadia dismissed the accusations as baseless.
Madam chairperson and members, this commission, which is empowered by the constitution to protect constitutional rights, is instead the one violating those rights. I mean, Madam Chair, in all fairness, how can a complaint regarding...
If that is the personal statement you are making,
speak, Madam Chair,
I will not allow you to accuse this commission of violating human rights.
Madam Chair,
you will not speak any further about
you
that.
You yourself, Madam Chair,
I will
came
ask
out
you to
and
leave.
Mocked.
She said the commission's position is solid and has investigated and condemned all forms of human rights and shall continue to do so. She reaffirmed Uganda Human Rights Commission's commitment to impartiality and dismissed the claims of siding with the government. Wangadia called upon the public to disregard and treat such statements as misplaced, unwarranted, and not worth the attention of independent-minded individuals in society.
Okujerega koti yafe chetuta sobode kumukiriza chagende na chumu maso.
The musician turned politician filed the complaint on December 7, 2018, alleging that security agencies blocked over 20 of his music concerts, confiscated his music equipment, and denied several people their right to earn a living because of political affiliation.
Andeta kwe mulugunya kwange emyaka jigenda mukaga jisukamu etano. Tebampa mukisa kweyogerako ate lwebampa do mukisa mulabye engeri gyeyisiza.
The Ikumbania of Bagwere Culture Institution, Geoffrey Wayawiri, has urged his subjects to embrace President Yoweri Museveni's 4-acre farming model in a bid to fight household poverty. The Ikumbania made the remarks yesterday, May 19th, during the closure of the first Jisisira cha Bagwere. It was organized by Queen Mother of the Foundation at Kachomo Revival Church Primary School in Budaka District. The Ikumbania pledged to use Kisisira cha Bagwere to promote the Bagwere. He also thanked the clan heads for entrusting him with the culture institution's leadership. Wayawire called upon government and non-government organizations to team up with the foundation in the fight against early teenage pregnancies in Bugwere. Ikumbania also inspected the stalls of traditional foods, attires, and preservation tools used to preserve. The first ever Kisesera Kyabagwere attracted over 600 boys and girls from the four districts that make up Bugwere Cultural Institution, including Budaka, Butebo, Chibuku, and Palisa. The initiative focuses on fostering cultural norms and morals among participants in preparation for their country and heritage. The initiative focuses on fostering cultural norms and morals among participants in appreciation for their country and heritage.